Justin Tucker all set, and we are set to see the cream of the crop in the AFC as we are underway here with the Ravens and the Chiefs. And we will not see a run back on the opening kickoff. This will be a touchback. Time to see what Patrick Mahomes can do here with his first possession. The quarterback out of Texas Tech getting set to lead this KC Chiefs offense.
And simply put, for many, he's the gold standard for quarterbacks in today's NFL because of his ability to create, find the open man, use all the different arm angles that he has. He's a complete package, and boy, his team loves to play around him.
Throwing at the outset, here's Mahomes. Now throw right side, taken in by the tight end, Gray. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27.
And Brandon, as you know, sometimes it's a lot tougher to run with these tight ends nowadays in the NFL. They're just bigger wide receivers. He lined up on the left side of the formation, ran a drag route across the field, and tried to work his way open. He was able to make the catch, but the defenders were there, couldn't do a whole lot with it afterwards. Simple drag route here, lined up out left. He tried to work his way back across the field. You probably saw me twitch there, partner, because I think he wanted the ball a little bit sooner. By the time he looked it in, defender was right on him.
Edwards-Helaire, they'll try to run for it. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive. Didn't get it by much, but bottom line, got the first down, avoiding that three and out. How vital is that on the first drive?
To me, it's like the first round of a boxing match. You know, it may not mean much right then and there, but you'd rather not lose it, right? So you want to go ahead and get it, kind of establish something early, and hope it can carry through.
Ball on the 39. Here's second down and 8. Now here's Mahomes. He finds his man, Sky Moore. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works. The 50. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down. Now back to throw. A quick throw knocked away and incomplete.
Well, anytime he reads man coverage, I don't think it's going to be the only time he'll try and hit that route to the outside in this game. He'll test the perimeter, but that time they were up to the challenge.
Second and 10. They fake the give. Now Mahomes. He'll check this one down to Pacheco. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area, that they want him involved. Just as you said, they want him to touch it either.
And it's a fumble. And it's picked up by the Ravens. Down, not the way they pictured that opening drive unfolding.
No, they were making progress. They weren't exactly in high gear, but they were making a few yards along the way, and now that they've coughed it up, you got to go back to the sidelines and regroup a little bit.
And Baltimore's offense set for this next possession. Jackson and the Ravens come up now, 1st and 10 at the 45. On play action, they'll throw. Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete.
It's always tough trying to keep your guy upright when he's trying to throw the football. When you're dealing with those big, bad guys on the defensive front, it's even tougher. And this time, those guys on the opposite side won the battle, getting to the quarterback and knocking him into an incompletion.
And he'll take it across the 50 and into Chief territory. That'll leave them with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
They'll try to run for the first with Henry. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. Give him 6 yards, and they do convert on third. A first down carry for Henry. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. Decided to hand it off that time on the run pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice steady gain.
Here's a 2nd and 5. And now Jackson will look to throw it. And he'll be upended at the 33 following a gain of 3. And guess what? It brings up 3rd down. They'll come to the line needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. Play action. It's Jackson. He's got his target. That's complete. And he'll be brought down with a 1st down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs' 20-yard line. They go play action with Jackson. Buying time to his left. The quick feet by Jackson. He'll wind up getting right about 4 there on the scramble, and it's 2nd down. On 2nd down, here's Jackson. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's 3rd down. And this will probably be the last play of the quarter. On 3rd down, Henry. And it'll be a minimum pickup here as it will take us to the end of the first quarter. We're scoreless after 1. Raven football here as we begin quarter number 2. As they've got it with a 4th down coming up. Tucker's kick is good, and the Ravens strike first at 3-0. So the defense are able to force their first turnover of the game, and then they add on to that by getting the field goal.
And you don't just want to take the ball away from your opponent, partner. You want to make them hurt as well. And if you don't score yourself on defense, turn it over to your offense and have them put points on the board.
And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. Kansas City taking the field for their 2nd drive. They fumbled the last time they had the football. Fortunate that it only led to a field goal. 3-0 the score as they start 1st and 10. Moore, the man in motion. Now a loose football. The ball comes out, and it's picked up by the Ravens. And they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line.
Okay, after those first 2 drives, I think there's a head coach who's going to be calling for CSI. They're going to want some forensics on this. What is going on with this ball club unable to hold on to the football and take care of it?
Yeah, 2 straight fumbles for them to start out.
Yeah, you would think that this team would come in ready to go. Sometimes just mentally not prepared, and it shows up in these types of play. And as an ex-defensive back, you love it when they let you play and jostle downfield.
Jackson's throw complete there to Bateman. And he's going to be brought down at about the 16. 2nd catch for him today, and it'll wind up a 1st down. Jackson options out left. He will push his way down to about the 14. 2 yards the gain on the keeper, and it's second down.
And if you like defensive football, focus on the defensive end on this play. He does everything exactly right. Reads the play and makes sure he spills it for a small gain.
Now it's Jackson. Looking left side, Andrews with it complete. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. Henry will get down close to the goal line, but not in, as he'll be marked down at the 1. Second and goal from the 1. Henry again. And he'll get in. Touchdown, Baltimore. Derrick Henry taking it in from a yard out. And the Ravens are able to stretch out their lead.
You think back to some of the great goal line bruisers of the past, the Earl Campbells, the John Riggins, the Marshawn Lynches. I think you can put Derrick Henry right in that group as he scores there with another patented Derrick Henry run.
Justin Tucker for the extra point. It's up and good, and that'll increase their lead to 10-0. So the drive there took 6 plays, and Derrick Henry able to finish it off with a touchdown run. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And job one here, Charles, just keep possession of the football. 2 drives, 2 turnovers to this point.
You're exactly right, Doctor. Hippocratic oath, first do no harm. And right now they're harming themselves on offense.
I like that. No one is mistaking me for a doctor, though. But thank you, Dr. Davis. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another 1st and 10. Mahomes on the give to Edwards-Helaire. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. Moore, the motion man. Now here's a fake on the jet sweep as he'll go instead with Pacheco. He lost 4 there, and it's 3rd down.
Another example right there how this defense really is winning the entire game at the point of attack.
Yeah, right there at the line of scrimmage, because they are dominating it. It allows their interior guys to get upfield and spill into the backfield. So how are you going to combat that? You know, because they bring in your tight end, keep him in, your running backs, they have to step forward. Bottom line, your offensive line has to block them first to give yourself a chance.
Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he's going to be taken down with the 1st down at the Ravens' 27-yard line. That gain on 3rd down, good for 28. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the 1st half, 10-0, our score. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. Looking to throw is Mahomes. On the throw, let him too much that time. It's incomplete.
Yeah, their back's up against the wall a little bit, and they come through by forcing an incompletion. Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple of more times and get off the field before giving up any more yardage.
Back to the air on second down. It's Mahomes. And that falls to the ground incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively. And now it brings up third down.
Oh, nice defensive effort there, providing the hit as the ball got to the receiver, separates him from the catch, and normally he's a sure-handed target.
Mahomes now to throw. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's fourth down.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Butker's kick here is good, and they get themselves on the board here. It's 10-3. So, Charles, they are on the board after that kick. So, three drives, 3 points. Obviously not the start that you were hoping for, but they're able to erase that zero off the scoreboard.
Yeah, I guess what you're saying is a point of drive is not what offenses are striving for by any stretch. They're happy they've got three now. They hope that unlocks their offense for bigger points down the road.
And out a little across the 25 to the 27. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. They're starting to put some space here. You know, first quarter, they didn't look so hot offensively. This second quarter, though, they've looked really good.
They jumped in the saddle in a big way now, and now they're in full gallop. I mean, before, kind of cantering around a little bit, right, trying to feel their way, not getting done what they wanted to. But somehow they put it together with play calling, execution, and now there's a pretty big gap.
And they'll look to make that gap even bigger here. That is incomplete.
They decided the opportunity was there and launched a deep ball, but he was unable to get away from the defender, couldn't create space, couldn't uncover the end of the route, and that one winds up incomplete.
On second down, here's Henry. And able to get this one all the way up to about the 46-yard line. And they're going to speed things up here. Draw play. This is Henry. And he gets it down to the 48. Enough for the first. 50 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries.
But we tend to give those running backs that are slashers a lot of credit. But how about guys who are maulers? Because that's what you want in short yardage situations. And we just saw that occur right there, didn't we?
Vertical. Evades the tackler. And now some space. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. Zay Flowers. 48 yards. And the Ravens will extend their lead in the final minute of the half.
Partner, to me, that touchdown had something that was kind of rooted in that group seeing the future. And what I mean by that is they had a plan. Let's find a way to score right here before the half. And that'll give us momentum going into the second half. Give us that cushion that we're looking for. They got that accomplished, scoring right before the half ended.
Footing always a concern, but the extra point's up and good. And the lead is now 17-3. 5 plays there on that drive. And it's capped off with a Ravens touchdown. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And he takes this near the 25, just a little pass there, called it the 26. The Chiefs going to go back on offense one final time in this first half. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. Second down and 4. Mahomes going to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. Now another timeout called for by the offense, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. He'll look to throw. Short throw hauled in by Kelsey. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. From the 44 now, here's second and four. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. So we have come to halftime in what's already a two-touchdown game. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everyone, to our brand-new studios here in downtown Orlando in the EA Sports Halftime Report.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. And all in all, a pretty solid return. Nearly got it to the 35. They'll mark him down officially at the 34. The Raven offense set to start this third quarter. They have to be pleased with the way that they've moved the football thus far.
And why wouldn't they be? Two touchdowns on a field goal in their first three possessions. They're playing so well right now, the field goal probably feels like a disappointment.
They juked him, and he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 69 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game. They've got the lead early here in the third quarter, and runs like that are how they establish that lead in the first half.
I love the fact that you're using the word lead, because they are leading from the front, pounding on the defense right now with the running game, and truly establishing themselves here in the second half.
They keep it with Henry on first down. And he picks up about six as he gets this down to the 41.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here, because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And that is incomplete.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
Able to find the open man. That's complete. Fighting his way through contact. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. That's a gain of nearly 40 yards on third and medium to pick up the first.
The tackling in this game has not been good so far. We've seen our share of missed tackles. Case in point, that one right there. And that miss led to another big play. I don't know if it's effort. I don't know if it's technique. But they'll have to work on that in practice.
They'll try and run for it with Henry. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. Derrick Henry with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Ravens take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead.
Well, this offensive line has really stepped up to the challenge here, because those Mastodons, they've been sensational, clearing holes all game long. And this is great work down here near the goal line to give their back the space he needs to work his way into the end zone.
Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and the lead now to three touchdowns at 21. The drive summary that time, five plays. And Derrick Henry able to finish it off with a touchdown run. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. McCole Hardman to return it from his end zone. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line.
So here's the Chiefs offense ready for their first reps in half number two. Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Steps away to his left. The ball comes out, and it's picked up by the Ravens. Well, if these guys wanted to get back in this game, they needed an almost perfect second half, and down three scores. A lost fumble here certainly doesn't fit into that plan.
That reminds me of my plan in college to get an A on the papers I turned in, but that didn't work out too well either. Too many mistakes by both of us. I mean, that's just pure and simple. And that's why that's exactly where they are in this ball game. They're going to need a huge turnaround if they want to try and win this one.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. After the fumble recovery, it's Jackson. Looking deep here for Flowers, and it is incomplete. Good positioning there downfield to break that one up. A third quarter action from Kansas City, second down and 10. Running from the gun with Henry. And good work there in open space. And he's got this all the way down now to the 32. 88 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon. He's turning in a pretty impressive performance running the football and a big reason why they have this nice lead.
And in days gone by, we would clip this out and put it up on the refrigerator, wouldn't we? Clip out the box score. Nowadays, not too many newspapers out there. Maybe you screenshot it online.
Accept the penalty, of course, and push the offense backwards a bit. Now they need 15 yards on this series after the delay of game. First and 15. They go play action now. Jackson. That is caught. Rashad Bateman. And he's going to be touched down, but he's got the first down.
Another nice play there. They've gotten down into the red zone in no time at all. That's what this offense can do when they get on a roll. And now they're set up with a first and 10.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Jackson. His throw caught right around the 6. And the Ravens are going to be set up with a first and goal coming up as they get him down at the 6-yard line.
And while we may be looking at the scoreboard, this offense certainly is not, because they're showing no signs of backing down, even with a 3-score lead here in the third quarter. I think they keep taking their shots. They've seen blown leads happen throughout this league. They don't want to fall victim to it themselves.
Inside handoff, Henry. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the 1. Yeah, so they get that one, Charles, on the right tackle.
Yeah, oftentimes at that spot, you're trying to work against a defender, trying to set the edge in the running game, and you're trying to drive around and get your body twisted so that he can't get there. Sometimes your hands get too involved.
A terrible spot for a holding call as he'll try again, but now from further back on first and goal. Throwing is Jackson. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
Second down, Jackson. Over the middle, complete. That's Flowers. A nice job to get 11 out of that pass play, but now they face a third and goal.
I think a lot of people ask the same question all the time. Why do we see so many slants in the red zone? Well, the windows are tighter. Everything's more condensed. It has to be quicker, and you've got to deliver the ball.
And they're going to get to him. A sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line. Call it a loss of 8 there, and it's going to lead to a fourth down. Fourth and goal. So Jackson will head to the Ravens sideline, and on comes Justin Tucker for the field goal try. Tucker's kick is good, and that will extend their lead even further. Well, I don't know if they would have gone for it on fourth and goal anyway, but the sack on third down pretty much made their mind up for them.
You're exactly right about that. And this is a tough place on the field to take a sack because, as you just noted, it took the decision-making away from them. Now they have to go for a field goal instead of potentially going for it.
Tucker now following the made field goal, set to kick it away. And no thought of bringing this one out. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll begin the drive at the 30. Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over. Well, this has been a tough one for them, Charles. They've struggled really on both sides of the football. And one thing that's really plagued them, the turnovers. They've had issues keeping the football in their possession.
And every game that's ever been played, all coaches talk about taking care of the football and limiting turnovers. And in this one, after we saw that first turnover, we worried that things would snowball, and it certainly did, especially on the scoreboard.
They'll start the drive here with Pacheco. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7, past the 30 to the 32.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Pacheco gets it again on second down. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. It goes as a loss of 6. And now third down. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we played 3 quarters. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. We're back now in KC. A lot of folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number 4. This offense on third down today, they've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 9. Throwing now is Mahomes. Working the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Those are the types of plays they probably wish they had made more of in the first three quarters. And this deficit going to be tough to overcome here in the fourth. But a nice first down and a pickup on that throw.
Yeah, and this is where, as coaches, you're looking for effort and execution. Even though the scoreboard is going against you, you want to find out who's going to fight, who's going to scrap, who's going to keep their heads up and continue to play.
And his throw is going to be incomplete.
They lead big, and a major part of that has been how they've taken their play to a whole new level this second half. No points allowed since the break, and you can add another incompletion to the total number that they forced in this runaway contest.
Now a second and 10. They'll drop to throw. This will be caught by Brown. It's going to be a nice pickup, but he also takes a pretty good lick at the end of that one. They need two. Here's third down. Now it's Mahomes again. Ball had his hands on it, couldn't bring it in. Pretty symptomatic of how this game's been going. Well, it just seems like all game long there hasn't been a lot of sync quarterback to wide receiver on this side of the football.
They haven't been on the same page, quarterback and receivers. Heck, they haven't been on the same grease board when you draw plays up. They haven't been on the same surface tablet that you look at on the sidelines. Nothing's worked for them. They've got to find a way to start matching each other's movements.
And he fumbled it. It's on the ground. And it's picked up by the Ravens. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line.
And with that kind of a deficit, you can't afford to make any kind of mistakes. But it's been pretty symptomatic of what we've seen all game with them, isn't it? Down this big in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you'd say an afternoon to forget, absolutely. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. And they have to be feeling pretty good. Comfortable fourth quarter lead as they take over following the fumble recovery. Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at their own 44. They'll start on the ground. It's Derrick Henry. And he'll take it across the 50 and into Chief territory.
97 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long.
Well, partner, Marvin, our number one stats guy, just handed me a little card that says he has 97 yards on the ground today. You think he's going to get the ball again?
I think so. Three away from that century mark, got to have it.
Yeah, and I think what they're going to call is one of his favorite runs, whatever he feels comfortable with, and what the offensive line has executed well today to try and get him over 100 yards. Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with, and throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to, and it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down. Henry will get it. He's been busy today. And this defense not ready for that one as he'll take this down inside the 25. The Ravens get a new set of downs, give them 17 on that pickup.
No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter, this is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're not going to throw it here. Just eat up that clock. And if you have the ball, they can't score.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on. Third down. They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains.
Henry out of the pistol. And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18. Call it a gain of 3, and it'll bring up fourth down.
Well, this was just simply excellent defense. On this third down, they had to be alert for the possibility of a pass, but that didn't stop them at all from understanding what was going on when they decided to run the football, and they just swarmed and stuffed them for almost no gain.
So Jackson will head to the Ravens sideline, and on comes Justin Tucker for the field goal try. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Raven football here as we welcome you back. They've got a fourth down here in a game that looks to have been decided already. Tucker's kick is good, and that will extend their lead even further. Well, ultimately, not really sure that they're going to need those 3 points, but they'll take the 3 and they pad that lead.
Yeah, this one's already wrapped up, but you and I both know, if you're an offensive coordinator, you never let up on the gas unless the head coach tells you to do so. And maybe you've actually clicked him off in your headset so you can keep calling plays and trying to add to this lead.
And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Comes Kansas City.
Well, CD, it's all window dressing at this point. I mean, the best they can do is end the game with a nice drive to maybe build some momentum to move forward into their next contest.
Yeah, and with how lopsided this game has been, even one score might not do a lot of cosmetic good on the scoreboard, partner, because it's just about looking forward at this point. Get a touchdown here, give yourself some positive momentum and reps to focus on when you get back to practice in the next couple of days.
With this game well in hand, perhaps we are seeing the coverage lighten up a little bit as they got burned there a bit for a first down.
But we certainly know the coach isn't happy along the sideline, because he certainly wants them to finish this one out the way they started it. He doesn't want to give up any soft completions, no late point. He wants his lead to stay right where it is.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Here's Mahomes to throw. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that. And oh, he coughed it up! And it's picked up by the Ravens. And he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line. And I don't know that that fumble's gonna matter a whole lot. You look at the deficit here in the fourth, it doesn't matter. The coach on the sideline still scratching his head.
Yeah, not only scratching his head, but probably writing a note or two about, we're gonna address this come practice next week, because maybe that's the reason we're down this far. Doesn't matter at this point, but being sloppy throughout the game, not gonna help him improve.
Fighting down past the 45 and taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give him a first down.
At carries like that, that's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out. And that was a quality play to start a new set of downs. That was simply an offensive line winning the battle up front and winning in a big way and giving their guy in the backfield a nice lane to hit.
They'll run it again with Henry. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. Henry up the middle. So the
final seconds tick away in this Baltimore victory. And it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all came together in the second half, and no points were allowed. That's a great way to close them out.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. From Kansas City, so long, everybody.
Up shot calling, pay what I bought it. New crib psychotic, I'm so iconic. Fly down to see the islands, she ain't even bring a wallet. They don't get it, but I got it. I'm so iconic, yeah. Straight out the Lennox, that phone for hours. I'm straight out of minutes. They calling up Deanna, straight out the business. We take out the Sims and then take out percentage. Period, break out the minutes from capital M. Now we straight out the sentence. They pay out, they pay out, they pay out. I'm finished. Then grade out the lake, house the bay, watch the women. I don't meet your maker. Lord, please don't save him. Minor bumps since I've been paving the road. I go to sleep, go major. Silver too, but I've been playing for gold.